Sleep is an act that we as humans have no choice but to take part in, but it leaves us in an incredibly vulnerable situation as we rebuild our energy for the next day. As we sleep, we are completely at the hands of the environment that surrounds us, and even more horrifying, our own minds. If you're watching this before bed, I might recommend keeping a light on, because in this 5-5, we're going to cover 5 terrifying sleep conditions. I hope you enjoy. Number 5. Exploding Head Syndrome. Before you get caught up in the incredibly hyperbolic name of this condition, I want to confirm that no, your head does not literally explode. But what happens is, in my opinion at least, much creepier. People who suffer from EHS experience what are called hypnagogic auditory hallucinations. For your better understanding of what that means, hypnagogic is the state your body is in immediately before falling asleep. So basically, victims, if you will, experience auditory hallucinations as they are falling asleep or are about to enter sleep. These hallucinations can be of a wide variety, but are essentially all forms of sudden, incredibly loud noises that startle them back into full consciousness. Personally for me, I will often hear a very loud, undistinguishable object fall to the floor and create a bang. I usually jump out right away, and though at this point I understand the sound was not real, I still have a much harder time falling back asleep, as I get an incredibly strange sensation that someone else is in my apartment. This, I believe, is simply anxiety as a result of the noise, but nonetheless, it's a very odd experience. Other people have described the noises to be things like gunshots, slamming doors, explosions, and even people shouting. As well, there have been some sufferers who have experienced visual bright flashes that complement the auditory hallucination. This is something I have never experienced. The hallucinations are never accompanied by any pain or headaches even, but the anxiety I stated I felt is very common. This means that, on the surface, the condition does not actually physically harm the sufferer, but if it happens persistent enough, it is possible it could lead to a fear of sleeping, which in turn could be early development for the sleep disorder sleep onset insomnia, which is defined as an extreme difficulty initiating sleep. This leads as a good segue for our next entry. Number 4. Fatal Familial Insomnia. This one, thankfully, I have no experience with, as it is essentially a condition in which a sufferer simply cannot go to sleep anymore, which, inevitably, leads to their death. It will start as simply as having difficulty falling asleep one night, and will progress rapidly over a short period of a few months until the person can no longer sleep at all. This entry, I should specify, goes further than being a simple condition, and is actually a rare genetic degenerative brain disorder that begins with what appears to be a simple sleep disorder. After a while of not being able to fall asleep, the sufferer will eventually experience severe physical and mental degradation. They may also experience dysfunction of their autonomic nervous system. This is the part of the brain that controls involuntary or automatic body processes, which means they may lose the ability for their body to automatically perform tasks such as body temperature regulation, breathing, or regulating the heart rate. This results in symptoms including high blood pressure, rapid heart rate, excessive sweating, difficulty walking, muscle twitches, hallucinations, and even weight loss. Although the earliest symptom is usually lack of sleep, an individual may also experience progressive dementia, trouble with memory, language, and behavior. They will also start to have vivid hallucinations and episodes of confusion. Inevitably, the individual will progress towards slipping into a coma and eventually die. The average survival span upon first symptoms is 18 months. There is no cure for the disease. The cause of the disease is a defect in what is called the prion genes in your brain. To put it in short terms, it is a gene defect in the brain that will begin to eat away at your nervous system. The gene is not hereditary, as it is only developed at the formation of the sperm or egg affected. It is extremely rare and typically only occurs in men and women equally in their late 40s to 50s, although it has been recorded in those as young as mid-teens and as old as 70s. My advice if you're worried? Try not to lose any sleep over it. Number 3. Sleep Hallucinations. Sleep hallucinations are sort of like a semi-dream state. The problem, though, is that you are really neither completely awake nor completely asleep. These often terrifying or creepy hallucinations occur while you are either falling asleep, in which case they are called hypnagogic hallucinations, like we learned earlier in the video, or when you are just waking up, which is called hypnopompic hallucinations. The hallucinations are a type of parasomnia, which is described as abnormal or unusual behavior of the nervous system during sleep. They take form mostly as complex visual hallucinations, though they can also extend to all 5 senses, and even the illusion of motion. Often, they appear as stationary images of people or animals, But of course, they really could be anything. The images may also be distorted in shape or size, and they can last for several minutes. It is commonly reported that they will disappear if a light is turned on. Perhaps the scariest thing about the hallucinations is that your mind can't often process if they are real or fake. When having an intense nightmare, you might wake up and realize right away that you were dreaming, and you're able to calm yourself down rather quickly. Some people, like me for instance, are able to recognize they are dreaming while they are still asleep. This means you can even shut off a nightmare or wake yourself up while you're having it. But with the hallucinations, they appear to be incredibly real, and as you are not really fully asleep or awake, your brain isn't always able to determine what it should believe. This can cause people to enter a state of terror or anxiety, causing them to jump out of bed or react to the hallucination. This can be dangerous as you risk injuring yourself in the process. This condition may be caused by many things. A lot of sufferers will also have narcolepsy. Some people may have it brought on by use of certain medications. Mental health disorders can cause it, as well as substance abuse. You may be at risk for this condition if you are using drugs or alcohol, or you have anxiety and other mood disorders. As well, insomnia can bring this on. Number 2. Sleep paralysis. This disorder I unfortunately started experiencing long before I ever knew what it was, and I'm glad I understand now as it has helped me immensely to curb my anxiety during episodes, though the early episodes were among some of the most terrifying moments of my life. Sleep paralysis occurs when your body is switching between stages of rapid eye movement, REM sleep, and non-rapid eye movement, NREM sleep. REM sleep is the part of your sleep when your brain activity increases almost to a similar level of when you are awake. This is when you have dreams. As a protective measure, your body puts itself into a state of paralysis, shutting down all voluntary muscles so you don't go off acting out your dreams in your sleep. Some people will enter paralysis before entering REM, or vice versa, they wake up before the paralysis has ended, meaning they are mentally awake, but their bodies are completely paralyzed. This includes the ability to talk or scream, which to me is one of the scariest parts of the episodes. Then there are the hallucinations that occur alongside. Many people report visual and auditory hallucinations along with an intense feeling of fear and panic. They will often become short of breath, and it is incredibly common to experience a feeling of an extreme weight on your chest. One of the more eerie things about sleep paralysis is that a lot of sufferers somehow experience the same visions. They are so common, in fact, that some of the figures have become known around the world as characters. There is Incubus, which is a devilish-looking creature that pushes on your chest, the Old Hag, who is a witch-like creature who does the same, and then the Shadow Man, who is a dark, tall, shadowy, man-like creature who stands over your bed in your room. I can also tell a few of my own experiences. I was in my bedroom with the door closed, and I realized I could not move again. Then, a very large, demonic-looking, floating shadow appeared across from me. It stayed and watched me, then began moving closer at an antagonizing slow speed. At this point, I had experienced it enough that, while still completely in terror, I was able to start wiggling my fingers and toes and attempt to move my neck until I was able to regain control of my body. This is the strategy I use every time I experience it now. Sleep paralysis is actually fairly common. Around 50% of people will experience some form of it at least once in their lifetime, but only 4% of people have ever had more than 5 episodes. Number 1. Sudden Unexplained Death Syndrome. This final entry is pretty self-explanatory, but that doesn't make it any less confusing or frightening. The rare disorder is simply when someone goes to sleep one night and then fails to ever wake up. It is also known as Sudden Arrhythmic Death Syndrome. It was first noted in 1977 among Asian refugees in the United States. Following that, it was discovered in Singapore. Scientists soon discovered that it seems to primarily affect Southeast Asia and other Asian populations, and mostly men. For the most part, the deaths seem extremely surprising, as the victims are usually very healthy young men with no known problems. In some cases, they had experienced chest pain in the week or so leading up to it, some a slight shortness of breath, and a very minute amount had fainting episodes, but nothing that could really predict such a sudden death. The causes of death, as discovered in autopsies, can range from different forms of heart failure to other rare genetic diseases that otherwise show no hint of their presence. But in 5% of all cases, even after an extensive examination, no cause of death is ever found. Unfortunately, this is only ever diagnosed after death, and the only way to prevent it is with an implantable cardioverter defibrillator. But without being able to predict a sudden death, there really is no way to stop it from happening. Had you ever experienced any of the conditions or disorders I mentioned? Let me know your story in the comments below. Thanks for checking out this Sci-5. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, check out my last video, 5 UFO Sightings Made by Pilots, and be sure to stay tuned for future Sci-5s on all things science and science fiction. And again, I'd like to give a big shout out to my Patreon supporters. Thanks for the appreciation and the motivation. It means more than you know.